In the spotlight this morning, we are catching up with a recent quiz show star. Last week, we told you that East Providence native Matthew Price would appear on national television as he was put to the test on Jeopardy. Let's take a look back at his winning moment.
Let's go to the man in the middle, Matthew Price. He's smiling. Why? What is saving Mr. Banks? Because he came up with the correct response also, and he wagered double his score. 11,200 the wager, 22,400. And we have a new champion in Matthew Price. 22,400 for this young man.
And Matt joins us in studio now to chat about his recent TV fame. Good to see you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here today. All right, can we start off with your audition?
Yeah.
Where did you audition?
I auditioned at the Renaissance in Providence back in May.
Okay, so you were actually in the audition room before Michaela, Brendan, and I were in there.
Yes.
Lucky you. People don't realize, right? You're sitting in this room with a bunch of people who are extremely smart.
Yep.
You're sitting in this room, you're thinking you're pretty good.
Yep.
Then you get up there.
Yep.
It doesn't go that well.
No, not at all. In fact, one of the audition questions that I was asked was in a show about TV cooking shows. Mm-hmm. And the answer was Top Chef. And I responded, what is sushi? So after that, I was like, wow, I'm never getting on the show.
And so how long after you do go through the audition process do you hear, you're going to be on the show?
I was sitting in my office about a month after the audition, mm-hmm. and they gave me a call and said, hey, do you want to fly out for Jeopardy? And I was like, absolutely.
Right. But does panic go through you? I mean, you know, you go through the audition, and hey, you know what, we're having fun. Then all of a sudden the message comes, says, I'm going to be on Jeopardy. Do you freak and go, oh my God, how am I going to do this?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I was like, I need to learn everything about everything. I had flashcards about any subject that you could imagine, mm-hmm. and I studied every single night, and anytime I learned something new, I had to learn something that was everything related to that new thing that I learned, and it was pretty surreal and intense.
Did you feel you had a stronger category or stronger knowledge of something other than something else?
Yeah, well, my strengths have always been in history and geography, so I kind of put those on the back burner, but I was making flashcards about, like, Russian composers, scientists, famous authors, and things like that, so yeah.
All right, they told us that the secret really is the buzzer.
Yeah.
Did you find that the case being the case when you actually got to the set itself?
Absolutely. So they give you pretty much the entire morning to rehearse. So all the contestants that are out there spend about 2.5 hours mm-hmm. Rehearsing on the buzzer, because it really is key to the game. Because when you're up there, you know, if you know the answer, at least one of your competitors knows the answer
right.
as well. And it's just getting that timing to ring in, because if you ring in too early, you're locked out for about a half a second and someone can swoop in and ring in and respond.
All right, so you get to LA, mm-hmm. you're ready to do the show, you walk out onto that set. What was it like being there? We've all watched the show on television, but then when you're actually standing there, it's a whole other ballgame.
Yeah, it was surreal. This whole experience has been surreal, but the set is a lot smaller than you think in person, but it's just like, wow, I'm here. I've been dreaming about this since I was a kid, and it's actually here.
And you look up and you see Alex Trebek.
Yeah. And he also surprised everyone, because he came out, he regrew his mustache.
Right.
So that was a really big, fun surprise for everyone.
What was the one thing you kind of took away from this? I mean, was there... You know, you do something like this and you gotta come away with some sort of...
It was a dream come true. I went out there with the goal of I just want to get to Final Jeopardy and not be in the negative at the end of the game. Then as I was studying, I was like, well, I just want to win one game. And then when I was out there, I was like, man, I really want to beat Ken Jennings' record. But it ended up great. Winning one game was a great experience. Then coming back on Monday's show, which I did not win, but I feel like I played well on Monday's show, and I was really proud of that as well.
Okay, when they ask you that final question and you've written down your answer, you've weighed your money, mm-hmm. in the back of your mind, going, what are you thinking? Are you thinking, man, I got this?
So I was pretty confident that I knew the answer on Friday. I had made it a point, because I heard someone on the radio talking about that movie,
right.
and I was like, man, this is the kind of thing that comes up on Jeopardy all the time. I really need to learn. I really commit this to memory.
Sure.
So when that clue popped up, I was like, oh wow, I got this. and so I was pretty confident. I was not confident in the fact that the current champion would not get it. And so when he didn't get it, I was like,
Oh my God,
I just went on Jeopardy.
I love that.
Yeah,
that's great.
Yeah.
Well, thanks so much for
Thank
being here.
For,
great to
for
have you here today.
Yeah.
Congratulations. And you can watch Jeopardy weeknights at 7:30 right here on WPRI 12.